Hello class, so today itutuloy natin ngayon yung business combination chapter 1 which is yung statutory merger and consolidation. Okay, so sabi natin meron tayong 5 procedures for business combination. So first is to identify the acquirer, next is to determine the acquisition date, calculate the fair value of purchase consideration transferred, recognize the assets and liabilities, and recognize if ever merong goodwill or gain from bargain purchase option. So take note, kapag yung purchase is less than 100%, so hindi kasi diba required na kailangan bilhin lagi yung 100% ng binibili nating company. So kapag less than, pwedeng magkaroon ng non-controlling interest or yung NCI, which will be covered sa ibang chapters ng ating libro. Okay, so first is to identify the acquirer. So ang sabi, kailangan mo talagang ma-establish kung sino yung bumibili. So mukha siyang madali tignan, pero minsan may mga sample problems tayo na hindi natin ma-establish kung sino yung acquirer. So according to PFRS 3, the acquirer is the entity that obtains control of the acquiree. So the keyword is the control. Who controls after the merger or the consolidation? So kung sino yung nagkaroon ng control after is the acquirer yun. Next is to determine the acquisition date. So it is critical to determine when is the acquisition date or when is the control of the net assets and liabilities or the shares was transferred from the acquiree to the acquirer. So kailangan natin yun kasi dun natin mame-measure kung magkano yung ipapasok natin as of acquisition date. So that's the definition of acquisition date. Relates to the point in time when the net asset of the acquiree becomes the net asset of the acquirer. So in essence, the date on which the acquirer can recognize the net assets acquired in its own record. So kailan pwede nang i-record ni acquirer? Doon yung acquisition date. Next is calculate. So ngayon, alam mo na sino bumili, alam mo na kailan binili or nagkaroon ng control. Ngayon, kailangan mo nang i-calculate how much is the fair value of the purchase consideration transferred or yung ibibigay ni acquirer kay acquiree kung magkano yun. So, the consideration transferred is measured at fair value. So, for example, nagbigay ako ng shares. Dapat, kunyari, binigay yung fair value and fair value. Imi-measure ko daw at fair value. And it is also calculated as the sum of acquisition date for the values. Okay. So ito yung mga sample. Kasi ito yung mga pwedeng considerations na ibigay ni acquirer kay acquired. So first is cash. Pwede niyang bilhin through cash or magbigay ng cash. Kapag cash daw ang binigay ni acquirer is kailangan natin i-measure at fair value of the amount of cash or cash equivalent disbursed. So kapag deferred payment naman, the fair value of the acquirer is the amount the entity would have to borrow to settle the debt immediately. So, ang gagamitin daw natin is incremental borrowing rate in case magkaroon ng deferred payment. Next is non-monetary assets. So, hindi lang naman through cash pwedeng magbigay ng consideration si acquirer. Pwede rin through PPE or property, plant and equipment, investments, licenses, and patents. So, kailangan din siyang i-record or i-measure at fair value. So this is in contrast with PFR 16 or past 16 of property, plant, and equipment and past 38 of intangible assets. Kasi ang sabi doon is initially record at cost. Pero under the business combination or PFR 3, when we measure the consideration transferred, we measure it at fair value or using the acquisition method. Okay, so thus it is earning an income equal to the fair value on the sale of asset. If the carrying amount of the asset is different, nagkakaroon ng gain or loss. Next is, bukod doon, pwede ring mag-transfer ng equity instrument. Ito yung sinabi ko na shares. Pwedeng shares yung kanyang i-transfer. So, acquirer issues its own shares as consideration. So, kunyari si A, nag-issue siya ng shares kay B para bilhin si B. So for listed entities, ang fair value mo can be shown sa quoted price ng shares. So as noted in the paragraph 53 of PFRS 3, these costs are accounted for in accordance with past 32. So ang sabi, kapag mayroong mga kailangang additional expense or mga dito, acquisition cost for equity related, it is treated as reduction in the share capital of the entity. So mamaya makikita tayo ng sample problems na may mga equity instrument issuance cost, mga ganun. So fourth, pwede ring kapag bumibili ka, hindi lang lagi asset, pwedeng liabilities undertaken. So kapag liabilities ang itinransfer, ang consideration is fair value or present value. Kasi diba, kapag sa liabilities is present value yung term natin of expected future cash outflow. So, then pwede rin contingent consideration or yung ibibigay mo kapag nangyari isang event. So it includes distribution if specified under future events occur or conditions are met. So pag nangyari, so minsan nagkakaroon ng certain probability, kunyari nag-estimate sila na ibibigay ko to, pero based ngayon, ang estimate ko is 10% chance na mangyari to. So, i-recognize natin based on that probability. Okay. So, sa purchase consideration transfer, so meron tayong mga iba't ibang cost na pwedeng makaharap. Kumbaga, kapag kunyari, nagbigay ka ng debt, nagbigay ka ng equity instrument, so meron tayong mga acquisition-related costs. So take note that acquisition-related costs are excluded from the measurement of consideration paid. Kasi ito ay not part of the fair value of assets and liabilities. So, sample, yung mga costs directly attributable to the combination such as legal fees, finders and brokerage fees, advisory are excluded in the net assets of the consideration transfer. So, lalo na yung mga indirect costs, general costs, these are excluded in the consideration transfer. Another thing na excluded is the cost of issuing equity instrument. So, sabi natin kanina, transaction costs such as doc stamps, professional advisor's fee, underwriting costs, these are included excluded and according dun sa standard is pwedeng reduction ng share capital or share premium. Okay, so hindi siya sinasama sa consideration transfer. Next is cost of issuing debt instruments. So yung mga directly attributable costs such as legal fees, finder's fees, same with equity instrument are treated as expenses. Also, indirect acquisition costs related to issuance of debt instruments are treated as expenses. Pero yung ito yung nabanggit kanina kapag related sa issuing stocks, debit to share premium, then kapag cost of arranging issuing debt securities, bond issue cost. So these are all not part of the consideration transfer. Okay. Recognition and measurement. So ito na yung fourth. So paano mo naman i-recognize yung net asset? Yung number three is considering yung consideration transfer ni acquirer. Yung number four is yung recognition ng net asset ni acquiree. So ang main rule natin dito is fair value. Ang gagamitin natin sa pag-consider ng kanila is fair value. So, it is the market-based measure in a transaction between unrelated parties. So, ito yung sabi nating arm's length transaction. So, this is the price that would be available in the market if ever na ibebenta ko. Kunyari, ang binigay ko is the PPE. So, how much is the fair value of that? It is the price that is available in the market if ever na ibibenta ko siya and mag-a-agree third parties even there are unrelated. Okay, so meron tayong fair value hierarchy. So meron tayong tinatawag na level 1 to 3. So level 1 inputs pertains to the fully observable and are unadjusted quoted prices. So example, sa equity meron tayong mga listed stocks. So meron silang unadjusted quoted prices. Level 2 inputs, directly or indirectly observable inputs other than level 1 inputs. So meron din tayong fair value hierarchy is level 3 unobservable inputs. So lahat to is allowed. Siyempre minsan kunyari, hindi naman lahat ng ating assets and liabs is merong quoted prices or merong available prices. So pwede tayong gumamit ng level 2 or level 3 kapag meron tayong other means of determining the fair value. Pero if ever na meron, priority may level 1, which is the quoted prices. So may iba't iba tayong valuation technique. So ang valuation techniques, ito yung kung paano i-estimate yung price in an orderly transaction to sell the asset or to transfer the liability. So, meron tayong three valuation techniques. First is the market or benchmark approach. So, ito, gumagamit daw ng relevant information na market available na information. Income approach is based on future economic benefit derived from owning the asset. So, ito, i-value mo daw siya based sa kikitain mo sa kanya. Next is the cost. So, sa business combination, ang preferred natin is the market or benchmark approach. And if not available, the income approach will be used. Okay. So, the keyword here, kapag magde-determine tayo, alin ba sa net asset ni acquiree ang isasama natin? So, ang keyword is identifiable. So, dapat identifiable and measurable yung assets and liabilities ni acquiree. So, the acquirer may be able to identify the assets and liabilities based on the balance sheet. So, ito yung mga pwede nating i-assume na assets and liabilities and how will we recognize and measure it. So, first is identifiable tangible asset. Tangible na kita, like PPE, inventory, and such. So, it is recognized only if it is probable that a future economic benefit will flow. So, technically, asset definition. So, isasama ko lang siya kapag probable na kikita ko or mag-generate ako out of it. So, assets held accounted for PFRs 5 are measured at fair value less cost to sell. So, exemption to. Kung makikita niyo yung mga under PFRs 5 is fair value less cost to sell or yung mga assets held for sale. So, yung AR naman, yung accounts receivable natin and PPE, wala silang valuation accounts such as allowance for doubtful accounts and ACDEP, accumulated depreciation. So, it is treated as net. So, pag tinransfer yung asset or binili or re-recognize, dapat at net amount. Next is intangible, identifiable, intangible asset. So, sabi nga natin, dapat identifiable. So, paano ba natin masasabi na identifiable ang isang intangible asset? So first is if it can be separated. Next is if it meets the contractual legal criteria. Okay, so according to PFRS 3, in process or in progress research and development, acquirer recognize all tangible and intangible research and development assets. So, kunyari, ongoing pa yung pag-produce ng intangible asset. Yung mga na-determine mo na or identifiable mo na na part is pwede mo lang i-recognize sa ating net assets assumed. Next, so, syempre, bukod sa pwede kang mag-assume ng assets, pwede ka rin mag-assume ng liabilities nila. So, kapag liabilities, same with number 3 natin kanina na true present value. So, actually, iniba mo lang yung concept. Kanina, si acquirer, ito si acquiree. Okay, so, contingent liabilities, present value or fair value. Mostly naman kasi sila is fair value talaga yung nagamitin. Okay. So, meron din mga other assets and liabilities such as employee benefit plans, indemnification assets, income taxes, employee benefits. So, pwede rin natin silang ma-recognize. So, take note for employee benefit plans, the asset or liability under employee benefit plans is not recorded at fair value. So, ito, meron siyang iba. Instead, a liability is recorded if the projected benefit obligation exceeds the plan assets. Then, asset naman, kapag yung plan assets exceed the projected benefit obligation. So, ganun yung treatment natin for employee benefit plans. Okay, so, kay indemnification assets naman, the indemnification asset has to be measured on the same basis as that of the indemnified asset or liability at acquisition date fair value. So technically, fair value lang din siya. So income taxes naman, according sa PFRS 3, it requires the acquirer to recognize and measure a deferred tax asset or liability arising from assets acquired and liabilities assumed in business combination. So, required din na magkaroon ng mag-account for potential tax effects of temporary difference and carry forwards an acquiree that exists at acquisition date or arise as a result of acquisition. So, meron ding mga deferred tax assets or liabilities that are generally measured at undiscounted amounts in accordance with past wealth. So, and it was not decided not to require deferred tax assets acquired in a business combination to be measured at fair value. Okay, so employee benefits naman requires the acquirer to recognize and measures a liability or asset, if any, related to the acquirer's employee benefit arrangement in accordance with past 19. So, the corresponding standard will apply. Okay, so measuring and recognizing goodwill or a gain from purchase option. So, ang point of view natin dito is accounting record ka ni acquirer or yung bumibili. So, nagkakaroon tayo ng mga goodwill or gain from bargain purchase option. So, si acquirer kasi, pwede niyang i-operate yung binili niya kung paano yung i-operate ni acquirer dati or pwede rin mag-change siya. Tapos, magkakaroon din tayo ng mga future earnings potential. So, sinasabi lang natin na yung consideration na binibigay natin may not be equal to the fair value of the net assets being acquired. So, nagkakaroon tayo ng goodwill and bargain purchase option. So, what is goodwill ba? Goodwill is the excess of, dito, yung the aggregate of 1 and the number 2. So, anong sinasabi ng 1? Ito yung mga considerations na binibigay ni acquirer. So, yung consideration na transfer niya, such as yung kung ano mang binigay niya, plus the non-controlling interest, which will be covered in succeeding chapters, and yung combination achieving stages. So, itong mga binigay niya, less yung fair value ng net assets acquired. Okay, so technically, in short formula, considerations plus NCI plus previously held interest minus yung net assets and liabilities. Pero dahil dito sa chapter 1, wala pa tayo na itong BNC. So technically, goodwill will be the consideration transferred less yung fair value ng net assets ni acquiree nung binibili natin. So, technically, tinitignan natin, kunyari, nagbigay ka ng consideration, nagbigay ako ng cash, yung 5 million kay acquiree. Tapos, yung net assets pala niya, 4 million lang. So, technically, nagbigay ka ng goodwill. So, meron kang 1 million goodwill na provided dun sa transaction na yun. Okay, so, ganun yung goodwill. Kabalik na rin naman niya, si bargain purchase option or si gain. Ito naman, yung consideration na binigay ko is 4 million, pero yung net asset pala niya, 5 million. So, merong bargain purchase gain. So, usually, goodwill yung nangyayari sa transaction kasi they don't usually sell at lower amounts than the net assets kung ikaw yung nagbebenta. So, take note that before recognizing bargain purchase option, you need to reassess muna if asset and liab are correctly identified, correctly measured at fair value. So, any remaining excess is treated as profit or loss. So, take note also that goodwill and bargain purchase option cannot be recognized in the same time. So, technically, isa dito mas mataas, parang ganun. Or pwedeng pantay, pero hindi pwedeng sabay na may goodwill and merong bargain purchase option. Okay, so before we go on that, magkaroon muna tayo ng sample problem para medyo mas ma-apply natin na paano ba mag-compute ang goodwill, paano ba i-determine anong fair value. Mas ma-appreciate natin kumbaga kung may kita natin yung sample problem. Share screen ko lang. Okay, so sa book natin, meron tayong illustration 1-1 and marami pang iba. So, i-cover natin actually ngayon is hanggang illustration 1-4 para hindi rin loaded since medyo mabigat siya dahil problem na siya. Kumbaga, ito na yung computation part and recognition na nung adjustments. Okay. So, illustration 1-1. So, acquisition of net assets. So, sabi, si Paul gusto niyang bilhin si Simon na company. So, nagbayad daw siya ng cash na 100,000. So, we need to recognize the consideration transfer. Kasi pag nagko-compute tayo kung goodwill or bargain purchase, we need to check lang naman magkano yung binigay versus magkano yung nakuha para makuha ko kung may goodwill or not. And ma-record ko sa books ko. So, diretso tayong tingin 100,000 yung cash consideration. Then, nag-issue siya ng common stock with a fair value of 25. Magkano yung fair value nito kay Paul? 20 yung par. Ito. So, sabi natin, kapag nag-recognize tayo ng consideration transferred under step 3, kailangan natin recognize at fair value yung equity instrument. So, 3,600 common stock multiplied by the fair value of 25 pesos. So, total consideration na binigay ni Paul kay Simon is 190,000. Then next, Number four, step four natin is determine the assets and liabilities na i-assume or yung binibili natin. So binibili natin kay Simon, given is the fair value and the book value. So take note that we need to consider the fair value of the net assets. So assets, 218,000 less 58,000 na fair value ng liab. So ganun lang siya kasimple. You need to compute for the fair value of the net asset. So ang binigay ni acquirer is 190,000. Ang nakuha niya lang is 160,000. So using the formula, the goodwill is 30,000. Next is to recognize kung magkano na yung books ni Paul after the business combination or the merger. Okay, so ngayon, binili niya tong kay Simon, di ba? Binili niya. So technically, inubos niya na yung meron si Simon. Natira lang kay Simon, I think, is the common stock, yung retained earnings, hindi niya binili. Ang binili niya is the assets, net assets. Okay, so magkano na ngayon yung balance ni Paul? So ang assets niya is 600,000. So at book value, take note na si Paul, at book value pa rin siya, si acquirer, plus the fair value of the acquiree. Kasi si Paul, magtutuloy naman yung business niya, di ba? So, at book value naman tayo kapag accounting, di ba? Hindi naman tayo at fair value. Dahil lang sa business combination, kaya at fair value natin tinignan yung kay Simon. So, we need to compute the book value of Paul plus the fair value of Simon. So, 600,000 less 100,000. Saan ang galing yun? Yun yung nabawas kasi nagbayad tayo. So, nabawasan tayo 100,000 plus the fair value of the assets. Next is to recognize the goodwill, 30,000. So, the total assets of Paul after the combination is 748,000. Next, liabilities. Liabilities at 240,000 sa book value niya plus the 72,000. So, yung 58,000. So, the fair value. Next is the common shares. The common stock of Paul is 200,000. So, 200,000 plus the issued common stock. So, nag-issue siya na 90,000. Pero, hindi yun 90,000 naka-recognize sa common shares. Kasi, we recognize common shares at par value. Then, APIC or share premium yung excess. So, magkano ba yung issue niya? 3,600. Magkano yung par value niya? 20. So, 72,000 yung kanyang common stock. Then, the excess, 90,000 less 72,000, 18,000 will be treated as paid-in capital in excess of par or share premium. Then, retained earnings will be carried forward, 160,000. So, total stockholders' equity is 450,000. So, ganyan yung mangyayari. Technically, yung binili ko, malilipat sa book ko at fair value. Pero yung book ko at book value pa din. Illustration number 2. So, ito naman, assuming na meron tayong contingent consideration. Okay, so sabi natin, so babalikan natin yung PowerPoint natin to discuss yung portion ng contingent consideration. Wait lang. Ayan. So, meron tayong mga provisional value. So, if the initial accounting is incomplete, so kapag hindi mo pa alam kung magkano, pwede kang magkaroon ng provisional values. And pwede rin siyang i-adjust as long as it is within the measurement period. Okay, so ito yung mga usually na ina-adjust. Mga goodwill, contingent liab, contingent consideration. Then sabi natin, ang measurement period is the period kung kailan pwede pang mag-adjust. So technically, the answer is 1-year period. So, or earlier, kung depende kung nakita nyo na yung mga kailangan nyo i-adjust. So ito kasi, it gives yung time, kumbaga reasonable time to obtain information necessary to identify and measure the fair value of the acquirer's assets and liabs. Kasi let's say na ngayon, nag-business combination and sabi niya, 50,000 yung ano ko, yung PPE ko, ganyan. Yung property, plant, and equipment. Pero later on, napatunayan nyo, after ilang months, napatunayan nyo na ay 60,000 pala. So higher pala dapat yung treatment ko ng fair value ko nung PPE ko. So this is the measurement period wherein we allow adjustments. Kasi posible talaga hindi naman lahat ma-determine mo at the acquisition date. So meron tayong binibigay na 1 year period. Okay, so balik natin dun sa Excel file. Okay. So, sabi dito, may contingent consideration. On December 31, 2024, si Peter Corporation, si Peter pa rin, nag-enter siya ng business combination by acquiring the assets and assumed liabilities of Saul. Yan. Si Saul din ba siya? Ay, si Saul, sabi na yun, nag-iba yun. Ah, okay, PNS din. Pero si Paul at Simon. Ngayon, si Peter and Saul. Okay. Si Saul daw, na corporation, will be dissolved. So, mawala na to. Biling niya lahat. So, ang consideration ni Peter is first share. So, 25,000 10 par, market value of 25 per share. So, anong pipiliin natin? Yung 25, yung market value per share. So, 25,000 multiplied by 25 pesos per share is 625,000 na common stock. Next, 150,000 notes payable. So, yun yung transfer niya. Next is contingent payment of 100,000. Sabi natin, pag contingent payment is pwede tayo mag-recognize based on the probable chance. So, 30% daw yung chance na ang agreement kasi is babayaran kita ng cash kapag yung average income mo during the 2-year period exceeds to 50,000. Pero by today, syempre hindi mo pa alam kung mag-meet ba niya o hindi. So, ang ginawa is nag-estimate, probable estimate na 30% na may chance na magbayad ako ng 100,000 dahil baka ma-meet mo. So, meron tayong 100,000 multiplied by 30%. So, total consideration given is 805,000. Next is step 4, net assets of acquiry. Magkano yung net assets nung binibili natin, which is si Saul? So, titignan natin, total assets, yung fair value na portion, 920,000. So, 920 less 60,000 accounts payable and other liabilities. So, ang total fair value ni Saul is 720,000. Then, ang goodwill. So, using the formula na consideration less net asset. So, 85,000 yung goodwill natin na i-recognize. Kasi mas higher yung consideration natin versus the fair value nung binibili natin. So, ngayon, i-recognize natin or i-recognize natin sa books ni Peter. Okay, so, recognize niya yung cash na binili niya, 40, 60, 200, 300, 350. So, yung fair values ng assets, kailangan niyang i-recognize. Then, in process research and development na 50,000. Tapos, goodwill na 85,000. Liab na 60 and 140. Then, notes payable. Then, estimated liability for contingent consideration, 30,000. Then, yung common stock, hatiin lang ulit natin. Sabi natin, binigyan niya ng 25,000. Yung 10 at yung 25,000 times 10, yun yung at par value. So, 250,000 lang yung common stock. Then the rest is paid in capital in excess of par or share premium, 375,000. Okay, so meron ditong mga binigay na iba't ibang ginastos ni Peter nung nakapag-merge siya. Yung sabi natin na other costs na pwedeng ma-incur. Okay, so sabi dito may finder's fees, accounting fees, legal fees. So these items, yung finder's fees, accounting and legal fees are treated as acquisition related cost na direct cost. Pero hindi natin siya ina-add sa net asset, sabi natin. It is treated as expense. So 65,000. Next, cost of SEC registration including accounting and legal fees. Cost of printing and issuing stock certificate. So these are related sa stock issuance. So, ang treatment is deduction of share premium or paid in capital in excess of par. Next is expenses ang treatment natin for indirect cost. So, kaya importante kanina na makuha natin kung paano i-recognize yung other cost. Okay, so ngayon nakuha na natin. Siguro gets na natin by now. Okay, may contingent payment, ganito yung recognition, how to compute the goodwill, how to entry the recognized fair value ni Saul. So, kung kukumpitin mo ngayon, magkano yung balance ni, kunyari, ang mga tanong yan. So, after the merger, magkano na yung building ni Peter? So, building niya, 400,000 plus 300,000. So take note, kapag acquirer ka, at book value ka, kasi hindi naman ikaw yung binili. Pero pag binili ka, at fair value, yung itutuloy mong libro niya. Illustration 1-3, provisional amount on asset acquired. Okay, so ito, ang sabi, assume naman na kunyari yung building daw dito, December 31, 20X4. Tapos, noong August 1, 20X4, which is 8 months after that, is na-receive yung final value. Ang sabi kasi dito, ang value ng building is, eto, yung kay Saul, ang value daw is 200,000. Eto, yung fair value, 200,000. Pero, after 8 months, na-realize na, wait lang, building is naging 320,000. So, check natin. Ito pala, sorry, naduling ako. Yung building stat is 300,000. So, naging 320,000 pala yung final appraisal. So, meron tayong 20,000 adjustment. At yung sinasabi natin na pwede pa nating adjust yung mga gantong situations given na it is within the measurement period. And, ayan. So, parang kumbaga, within 1 year pa siya, so, pwede pa nilang i-adjust. Lalo na kung reasonable naman yung naging adjustment and material for them both. Okay. So, next, illustration 1-4. So, assuming naman na yung sinasabing expected probability, itong 30,000 na contingent payment. As if, based sa kanilang assumption is, dapat pala 50,000 to, ganyan. So, dapat ano ha, parang existing na yung fact as of acquisition date, pero meron lang improved information na nakita yung mga parties. So, pwede mo pang i-adjust yon yung 50,000. So, mababawasan yung good, ay magdadagdagan yung goodwill natin. Okay, so ganyan yung mga pwede pang magkaroon ng adjustments, kumbaga sa ating goodwill. Balik ka lang. Okay. So, yan, nabagay natin measurement period. So, sabi natin, is pwedeng mag-retro adjustment, kumbaga as if nangyari na siya before, di ba? Kasi within measurement period pa naman siya. So, yes, that concludes the discussion for today. Bale, magkakaroon pa ng part 3 yung chapter 1. Kasi medyo mahaba talaga siya. And since sabi ko nga is 5 chapters lang yung buong business combination. Pero syempre loaded siya. Sa isang chapter loaded siya. So hatiin pa natin para dun sa ibang illustrations and discussions. Thank you!